I want to tell you about a clinical law that we use, which is Alexander's Law. We use this in nystagmus, and it's useful because it tells you the direction where the nystagmus is going to be worse. And so even though we name nystagmus for the fast phase, so for example, downbeat nystagmus is going to be fast phase down, it's actually the slow phase that is the pathologic portion of the nystagmus. So it's the slow drift upward that is pathologic. The downbeat is a corrective saccade to get the fovea back on the target. And so when we look in a patient, for example, who has downbeat nystagmus, you know that the paramedian tract in the brainstem has to talk to the cerebellum. And the part of the cerebellum that is involved in this fine motor control is the cerebellar flocculus. And in the flocculus, you have the granular cell and the Purkinje cell in the cerebellum. This Purkinje cell is going to talk to the superior vestibular nucleus that is also receiving innervation from your ear, but not the hearing part of your ear, the vestibular portion of your ear. But in this case, the signal has been disrupted from the supranuclear component. And so this is a central vestibulopathy. So we have a central problem, either in your brainstem or in your cerebellum, that is causing this signal to be abnormal. This is an inhibitory signal, so it will lead to the superior vestibular nucleus stimulating when it's not supposed to. And that means the superior rectus muscle is going to fire and the eye is going to go up. That pathologic slow up phase must be compensated for by a compensatory downbeat nystagmus to keep the eye on the target. And so when we have a downbeat nystagmus causing the slow pathologic up gaze, the fast component is going to be carrying the eye back down. And so for Alexander's Law, what that means is if you're looking down, the eye will drift up, and then you'll have to compensate with the downbeat nystagmus. And it's the same for upbeat and up gaze and lateral gaze. If you're looking in the direction where the problem is, it'll be worse. And that's kind of a general rule for everything. You have a sixth nerve palsy, your double's going to be worse when you try and look in the direction of the sixth nerve palsy. And it's kind of the same thing with nystagmus. You'll be worse in the direction where the weakness is. And because the problem here is slow pathologic drift up, it'll be worse. Down gaze. And that is Alexander's Law.